everyone, welcome to Morning English. This is January.
Hello everybody, this is Nora. 欢迎大家收听早安英文。
Nora, have you heard Lang Lang now has a baby boy?
Yeah, I saw on Weibo that Lang Lang and Gina welcomed their first child. 我最近也在微博上看到了朗朗和吉娜官宣生子了。
Yeah, and they shared a really cute picture alongside the news. 他们还分享了一张特别的照片。
Yeah, a photo of them holding their little one's hand. 就是一家三口手握在一起的照片，真的是非常的有爱了。
Yeah, a Weibo user commented that the baby's fingers look really long. He might be born to be a pianist too. 就是说小宝贝的手看起来很长，说不定以后也会是个钢琴家。
这也看得出来吗？ Well, it sounds very possible though.
Yeah, and social media has been overflowing with congratulations for the musical couple. The pianist fans sending messages of good wishes.
是的，那么社交媒体上呢，充满了大家善意的祝福。那么这个地方呢，我们就用到了一个词 overflow。Flow 呢，本身就有流动，然后还有溢出的意思。前面呢，加上一个 over， 表示超过。那么这个单词Overflow 就可以表示充满。
对，我觉得这确实是一个非常可喜可贺的事情啊。
嗯，而且你想想，小宝宝还在他妈妈肚子里面的时候呢，就听着爸妈妈弹的钢琴声出生了，说不定之后真的就有可能成为一名钢琴家。
Yeah, it runs in the family. So in today's podcast, we're going to talk about the baby's father, the renowned pianist Lang Lang.
今天呢，给大家送个超棒的福利，早安英文会员课程的七天免费体验权限，只有十个名额哦。同时呢，大家也可以加入早安英文的 Telegram 社群，来群里和我们一起交流。社群地址和七天会员的免费领取链接都放在评论区了，欢迎你来。
那可以说朗朗的成就应该是世界瞩目的。
Yeah, he is considered by many as one of the most famous and accomplished classical musicians of modern time.
对，朗朗被许多人认为是现代最著名、最杰出的古典音乐家之一。那杰出的，我们刚刚就用到了一个单词 accomplished。
对，那这个单词其实非常的好记 ，accomplish 这个做动词呢，就是指实现、完成的意思。那么后面加了一个 ed 的后缀就变成了形容词 accomplished， 意思就是杰出的。其实我有一个感受啊，就是每次看他表演的时候觉得他非常的有激情，因为每一次都在手舞足蹈。
是的，有人就评价他的表演说 Lang Lang has conquered the classical world with dazzling technique and charisma.
Dazzling 这个单词指的就是令人眼花缭乱的，那么后面这个单词charisma 指的是一个人的魅力，那么这句话的意思就是说朗朗以眼花缭乱的技术和魅力征服了古典世界。
Yeah, and he has triggered in more than 40 million Chinese children learning the piano. 他的成功呢，也促使了很多中国儿童开始学钢琴。那其实他自己本身应该也算是一个钢琴天才了。
Yeah, he's a child prodigy indeed. When he was only 2 years old, he was very sensitive to music melodiesAfter he watched Tom and Jerry, he could immediately play the music from the cartoon by himself on the piano.
那 Nora 刚刚说到的这个 prodigy 这个单词呢，就可以表示奇才、神童。后面 sensitive 这个单词呢是敏感的意思。在朗朗两岁的时候呢，他就已经对音乐的旋律非常的敏感了。在他看完动画片《猫和老鼠》之后，他就可以自己在钢琴上弹出旋律。
Yeah, he's absolutely a genius.不过我觉得之所以他能够成为享誉世界的音乐家，也与他父亲离不开关系。
Yeah, he was brought by a tyrannical father.
Tyrannical 这个单词呢，其实可以指专制，那刚刚形容他的父亲说是 tyrannical， 就是说对他非常的严格，那么他从小就是在这种严格的教育下被培养长大的。
对，所以朗朗的爸爸也就是我们说的那种虎爸、a tiger dad.
Yeah, he had to practice piano at least 8 hours a daySometimes in the middle of the night, his father would wake him up to practice piano. And when he was being disobedient, his father would beat him harshly with a belt.
哎，真的是太严厉了。朗朗每天呢，至少要练琴8个小时，有的时候半夜会被父亲叫起来练琴。那如果朗朗不听话的话呢，他的爸爸就会用皮带狠狠地抽他。
对，那么如果形容小孩子不听话嘛，我们就可以用到一个词 disobedient。Obey 呢，我们知道是顺从，变成形容词就是 obedient， 表示非常顺从的、听话的。前面加上一个否定的 dis 前缀，就可以表示不顺从的、不听话的 disobedient。
对，那除了打骂这件事情呢，其实他的父亲还做过一些比较极端的事。
After being rejected by the Central Conservatory of Music, his father gave him a pack of sleeping tablets and urged him to swallow them.
哇，这个真的特别的难以想象啊。
对。
就感觉都有一点体罚的味道了、那说到了这个 sleeping tablets 其实就是指的安眠药，所有的小药片我们都可以叫做 tablets。 那么11岁的朗朗因为当时被中央音乐学院所拒绝了，他的爸爸呢就强迫他吃下一整瓶的安眠药。
Yeah, it's really harsh. And after朗朗refused to do so, his father suggested they jump from the balcony of their apartment.
Wow, that's so extreme. 太极端了吧，就是当朗朗拒绝去吃这个安眠药的时候，他爸爸还放狠话说他们两个要一起跳楼。就感觉特别的残忍啊。那朗朗到底是自己怎么看待这样一段经历的呢？
Well, he said he had a tough time. He almost gave up, but the music kept calling him back.
看来还是最后音乐拯救了他。我记得他之前还说过， As a kid, I sometimes hated my father, but I gradually understood that he and I share the same dream.So over time, I forgot what he did.
对，他小时候也是恨过他爸爸的，不过他最后呢，也理解了他的父亲，选择忘记那些伤害。
是的，他爸爸那种看似极端严苛的训练方式，其实虽然让他缺少了童年，但是在客观上呢，却帮他夯实了钢琴的基础。
Yeah, after all, every coin has two sides.
Right, but what surprised me most is that although he grew up in a relatively high-pressure family environment,He maintained a lively and funny personality.
是的，我也非常佩服他这一点，因为即使在比较高压的环境下成长，他的性格却并不压抑。
And actually, he's very open-minded about children's education.
Yeah, and he was once asked in an interview if he will let his child practice piano. He said he will definitely let him practice the piano. That's for sure. But he doesn't want to put a limit on the child's future.
对，就是说他肯定是会让孩子练琴的，但是呢他并不想限制孩子的未来，因为他说至于当不当钢琴家，这不是我的选择，而是孩子的选择。
那我觉得如果是我的话，也会比较赞同朗朗的教育方式，毕竟像他爸爸那种比较严苛的这种训练方式不一定适合每一个小孩。好了，那今天的节目呢也聊到这里结束了。 That's all for today's podcast. This is Nora. Thanks for listening.
This is Jen. See you next time.
Bye. 今天的节目就到这里了，大家别忘了去评论区领取我们的福利，早安英文会员课程的7天免费试听名额，只有10个，先到先得。最后，大家如果想加入我们的听众群，也可以在评论区置顶找到我们的 Telegram 社群地址，欢迎你来玩。
This podcast is from Morning English.
学口语就来早安英文。